Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can use QuickTime Player to trim your videos. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon and there you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So if you've taken some videos and you want to trim a little off the beginning or the end or take out a section in the middle, you can do that using the QuickTime Player. You don't have to go to a full-fledged editing app like iMovie. So QuickTime Player should be the default app whenever you double-click a video file on your Mac. Now it appears that really all you can do here is play the video. It is called QuickTime Player after all, but there are some editing features as well. If you go to Edit, Trim, you could enter a mode where you can trim a video. Command T is the keyboard shortcut for this. If you go into this mode, you see this strip here at the bottom with a yellow box surrounding it. You can click and drag the ends to trim off some from the beginning and the end. When you've got it just where you want it, you can hit the trim button and the beginning and the end would be gone and you just have this section in the middle. Now if your video is long, dragging here is going to move pretty quickly and it's going to be hard to figure out exactly where you want to cut the video. But if you click and hold and wait a second, you could see that the area at the bottom expands and now you have finer control over this location. As soon as you release, it snaps back. You can do the same thing with the beginning here. Click and hold and now you have finer control. When you hit trim, you're left with just the section in the middle, the section that was in the yellow box. Now one of the downsides to using QuickTime Player for anything is the export options are very limited. You can only export as some standard video formats. So you can't set specific export options and compression options. However, when you trim like this and then you go to save, you'll be saving it using the exact same settings as the current video. In other words, it's going to be lossless. It's just going to cut some off the beginning and the end, but it's not going to change the format or compression or anything of the section that you keep. Undo works really well with this. So even though I've trimmed some, if I hit undo, you can see I can go back to the full length of the video there. Now what if you don't want to trim some off the beginning or the end, but you want to take a section out of the middle? You could do that as well. In the normal playback mode here, there's an option for split clip, which is Command Y. So position the playback head where you want to make the first cut and then you can use split clip or Command Y. Now you go into this mode that's kind of like trimming. You've got the strip here at the bottom and you can see the cut there. You also have a red line that you can click and drag to reposition where the next cut will be. So I'm going to make another cut right here and I'll do Command Y to make that cut. And now you can see I've got three sections. You could use these sections to actually move things around. So I could actually reorder the video like that. Or I could select the middle section and then hit delete and it gets rid of it. So now I hit done and you can see now I've got a total of 18 seconds of video where before there were 26. That middle section is now missing. You can use undo on this as well to get back to the original 26 seconds. And actually those split clips are still there. So you can continue to use undo to get rid of those. And now you're back to the original video. When you do something like this, when you split a clip and then you remove a section from it, you lose the ability to save it. So you can't save it like you can with trimming. You have to then export using one of the standard video formats, which may not be a problem. If you're already using 1080p video, then exporting as 1080p video isn't going to be that much of a difference. So there's a lot you can do here in QuickTime Player. Matter of fact, not only can you trim and take out a middle section of a video, but you can also insert other clips from other videos. So you can merge videos as well. So I should add that you can also trim videos in the Photos app. So if you keep your videos in there, you can go to a video and then you can hit the Edit button. And then there's a little Settings button there with Trim as an option. If you go into that, you're in the same trim mode here. You can move the front and back. You can click and hold for more accurate precision there. And then you can hit trim and it will trim the video. And then you hit done and now you have that trim video in your Photos library. You can also get it back by going to edit, and like everything else in Photos, you can revert to original. So when you do that, you'll end up back here with a video of the original length. So you're not permanently changing the video in Photos. You're just trimming it so now you're viewing a smaller section, and also when you export or share, you'll only be exporting and sharing that section. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.